Hi, I'm Jill, curator of anthropology and exhibitions here at the Boonshoff Museum of Discovery in Dayton, Ohio. Today, we're in our biology collection. This first room that we're in is our entomology collection. Entomology is the study of insects, and in this room, there are thousands and thousands of insects from all over the world. My very favorite are the butterflies. So today, I'm going to show you two of my favorite butterflies that we have in the collection. First, this. Anybody know the name of this butterfly? Yell it out if you know it. These are monarch butterflies. Monarchs are probably the most recognizable type of butterfly in the entire world. That's probably because they migrate all over North America. They have a very distinctive color and pattern, and this color helps protect them. Monarchs are actually poisonous when they're eaten by lots of different creatures, so it protects them. There are even butterflies out there that pretend to be monarchs, even when they're not, to kind of mimic that poisonous quality of the monarch butterfly. Now, if anybody has picked up a butterfly that's maybe kind of passed away and you feel its wings, you get some of that pigment on your fingers. That's because these wings are actually pigmented with color. That's why we get this color. So if we move it around like this, the color looks the same when we do that. So I want you to remember that pigmented color stays the same when I show you my next and very favorite butterfly. So this butterfly comes to you from South America. So you probably haven't seen this one, unlike the monarchs. So look at these beautiful butterflies. These are called morpho butterflies. And they're pretty different from the monarchs because when we move them like this, the color slightly changes. While these might look blue, they don't have that blue pigment. They basically have iridescent scales all over their bodies that reflect the light. What's fun about these morphos are all boys. And they have these beautiful blue wings because they're trying to get a girlfriend and they want to flutter those wings around to attract the girls to them. But do you think having blue wings like this in South America is a good thing to attract attention? Maybe not if you're trying not to get eaten by other creatures. So what's fun, you can't see because the way these are pinned, but the other side of these wings are brown. So when these boy morphos would land on a branch, they would seal those wings up and kind of camouflage themselves so they could be blue or brown. The girls are brown all the time because they don't need to attract the attention of the boys in the same type of way. So again, when we move these, they're iridescent. Can you think of anything in your own home that's iridescent? Let's go out to the lab and I'll give you an example. So we are back in the lab to continue our discussion on iridescence. So think about those morpho butterflies and how they change color when we move them. What is iridescence? It is the refraction of light. So it basically makes something look like, as it changes angles, the color of it changes. So what do you have in your own house that also has that iridescent quality? One thing that I know I have lots of in my home are these things, bubbles. I stole these from my son, David. I promise, bud, I'm gonna bring them home, promise. So let's see some iridescence at work. Open up those bubbles. Now everybody take a deep breath in. Just give it a minute, one more. And then blow. See if I can catch one. So you can see as I move it, let's see if the camera can pick it up, how it changes color. So you can do this at home and appreciate the properties of iridescence. Have a great day. I'll see you next time. Bye.